untuk lokasi dibanding dengan film-film sebelumnya ini yang terbanyak, baik outdoor maupun studio.
Toilet ini kita bikin nggak biasa karena di sini banyak koreo. Ini ada engsel, bisa geser.
Action.
Gimana caranya kata Gerard biar bisa lebih cepet movable-nya, akhirnya gue bikin model buka tutup engsel gitu, dan semuanya ada jumlahnya 4 kubikel. Kalau untuk scene fighting-nya kita bikin agak lebih besar dikit.
Semua scene totally different, sangat berbeda satu sama lain.
Wide, extreme wide, malah landscape yang nggak ditemuin di kota besar, ada tebu, penjara juga yang secara view luar biasa.
Huge set, you can see amazing location in Gombong. When as soon as we saw it, we knew immediately we wanted to use this place because of the structure, the layout. Like I haven't seen anything like this before, and I think figure it'd be really interesting for audiences to see something like this.
Tiap-tiap jendelanya kita coverin semua dengan teralis-teralis. Semuanya kita coverin dengan teralis. Terus di pinggir-pinggirnya kita bikin shelter-shelter. Panjangnya satu shelter ini tiap sisinya ada 25 meter dengan lebar 2,5 meter.
Lumpur setinggi mata kaki, kemudian ini semua nanti dibikin hujan sederas-derasnya rata. Sementara tantangan kita adalah matahari di Indonesia yang selalu naik turun, makanya kita bikin silk ini 20x50 kali 3, jadi gede banget ini. Seperti Pentagon ini, seperti Coliseum Gladiator, cocok banget sama pertarungan prison riot yang benar-benar terkurung di dalamnya.
Every department can be able to kind of like monitor things. I mean, like obviously like the DOPs that are operating, so they're seeing everything live. I was blown away by the setup and blown away by the system and realizing how easy it was to be able to kind of monitor the footage and also be able to edit really quickly. With the Q-Tech system that he has, like literally the moment I've called cut on something, if I'm sort of like, oh, maybe that take is okay, I can check it immediately. It's in my hard drive. So I can just drop it straight in, chop, 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 and then play with it. And I know already now, okay, that take was good, next shot. Or that take is shit, let's go again. So it's the speed of it that I really love. When I do that editing on location, first and foremost, the main reason to do it is to know that I have my shots. It's to know that I have that action scene working before I leave that location. We're not going to have to come back and shoot extra stuff because I fucked up and didn't realize I didn't have it in the first place. But the second part, and this is like almost equally as important, is that thing of like, when we shoot these films, they're hard, they're stressful. Everyone's anxiety levels start to rise as production goes on. And this is a long production. This is like 6-7 months. So when you're forced to spend that much time with the same people, your brains are about to explode after a while. So the benefit of doing those edits is that I can show people cuts, I can show people, oh hey, you know how shitty the car chase stress is right now? How hard it is, how miserable it is, how much time we're losing every day? Okay, well this is the first 4 days of shooting, this is the edit of that footage. Take a look at it, like it's working, what we're doing is good. It's hard, but it's good. And if we just keep working at it, if we keep going at it, it'll get better and it'll look better and it's gonna be better. And so it kind of works as this morale booster for all the crew then and the cast. They can see that, you know, all the misery and the mayhem is worthwhile.
Ya, di sini kita menggunakan hampir sekitar 60 tipe jenis senjata. Begitu bervariasi, jauh lebih banyak dari Dread 1 dulu. Kemudian yang menggunakan juga jauh lebih banyak. Dari Dread 1 hanya pasukan khusus dengan gangster, sementara di sini gangsternya jauh lebih lebar lagi.
Seorang yang mungkin bukan dunianya dari segi hiruk pikuk dunia gemerlap, tapi dia cukup punya punya hubungan dengan dunia malam sebagai seorang yang katakanlah seorang pembunuh.
Kerjaan ini pilihan kamu?
Yang lama untuk mempersiapkannya sih prakoso. Warna rambut kita rubah, kita tambahin jenggot, kita bikin dia kelihatan lebih tua, kita bikin dia kelihatan lebih kasihan. Kita ingin orang tuh ada simpati sama prakoso meskipun dia pembunuh bayaran. Action!
For Veranda, we kind of wanted to go for a bigger, more cinematic look.
We have moments where we use very composed camera movements. So it's kind of a combination of slow dolly shots, big wide shots, and then we go into the fight, where it's obviously hand to hand. So we go back on the fig rig for those.
Untuk adegan balap mobil gitu ya, memang kamera movementnya jauh lebih liar dari ada kamera yang menggunakan alat berat. Contohnya pakai 4 crane besar, terus kamera kita gantung di atas. Kita nge-set angle aja kita perlu ngeblok jalan dengan banyak koordinasi.
Nah, tolong bantuannya juga bahwa nanti mobil-mobil yang keluar ini harus teratur. Tidak ada penumpukan di tengah-tengah sini, Bapak.
We kind of wanted most of the characters to have a different look about them, so there's a different color feel. So Bejo, for example, we're using lots of reds. When we go into the kitchen with the assassin, it's very cold and clean and white.
Desainnya dari permintaan director. Director minta setiap scene, setiap lokasi kita punya beberapa konsep warna yang beda-beda. Tidak semua dibikin flat, tidak semua dibikin sama.
It's a mix of different styles. So, like, there'll be certain scenes that call for that kind of chaos. There's certain scenes where we establish traditional elements. So, like, we have a scene with like a Rayog performance. So we decided to use some of the source material, audio from the performance, but then fuse it with like a dramatic score that kind of like gives it more tempo and keeps pushing the scene forward. We have Indonesian elements, we have Indonesian instruments, we have electronic score, we have that sort of like crazy high octane stuff as well. But then mixed in with all of that, we have these real nice sort of like emotional beats where we sort of introduce like strings and things like that then as well. So it's a whole collage of different styles, but like with one central theme that kind of hangs everything together then.
Kita harus bisa menggabungkan segi tradisional yang tarian reog itu dengan scoring kita sendiri.
Lebih ke apa ya, adrenalin dari percussion based sih, jadi lebih banyak variasi-variasi perkusi yang terjadi. Yeah.
One reason why I love scoring films is because all the answers are in the film. You're never at a point in the scoring process where you're going, I have no idea what to do, because you have this really great guide, which is the film and the director, and really bring across the character of the film, and to really reach out and grab the audience and make them feel even more a part and more enthralled in the picture.
Alhamdulillah, kita mendapat jaringan distribusi yang sangat baik, sangat positif, di mana distribusi di Indonesia tetap kami sendiri yang jalankan merantau film, di Jepang oleh Kadokawa Pictures, di Amerika dan beberapa wilayah lain yang dipegang sama Sony Pictures itu dirilis sama Sony Pictures.
Basically, one of the great things about this film is that it already has an audience. You know, the first film did a great job of breaking in and breaking an audience and being able to be exposed as large and wide as it has. It now has a following. A lot of people are still discovering the movie, and they're going to continue to discover it up until this film is released. And so this one has a great opportunity. And Gareth has some really exciting tricks in for people, and I think people are going to expect one thing and get another in a really exciting way. And so I think this film, first and foremost, it's going to be a perfect expansion in terms of story and action, and it elevates the bar in terms of action in a serious way. I think people will be very happy to see what he's been able to do here.
Every film is like a different challenge, and you know, you make tons of mistakes off everything you do, and we made loads of mistakes on Maranto, made loads of mistakes on The Raid, and the goal is to just learn from each of them and try to kind of not make those mistakes again and better yourself as a filmmaker and better yourself as a crew and better yourself as a talent.
Bisa dilihat, semua tetap kita bawa silat, agresif silat.
Ditontonnya itu seperti beneran ya.
Like, it's never going to be for everyone. Whoever wants to watch it and enjoys it, that's great. And that's all you can really hope for.
Kalau film Indonesia separuh aja semangatnya seperti ini, ketelitiannya, maka film Indonesia akan sangat bagus.
Begitu banyak fighter yang terlibat di sini. Ternyata mereka juara nasional, ada yang medali emas, ada dari PON, SEA Games, dan seterusnya. Ini membuat kita wow, begitu begitu dahsyatnya ini, dan ketika film ini jadi, semoga bisa jadi kebanggaan kita semua.